So for me, it's about working on that run and getting it back to a place that I can feel confident to hop on any start line in the world and go, right, I'm ready to win this race.
Jumping up and down the floor.
How important is the training hard and blah, blah, blah. I said, training hard's the easy part. It's doing all the other little things right. It's coming home after 5 hours on a bike or a 2 hour hard run where you've been running under 6 minute miles and you're bugging. Jumping in the ice bath, doing the rollers, you know, eating the right food, the timing of eating the right food. All of those things, they all matter so much that was the tiring part, actually doing all those little things. Just going out for an hour to 5 hours of training is, well, it's almost the fun part. You know, your body turns up and you do it. Keeping your body healthy so you can keep performing consistently, and what you've got to do to make it consistent, that's hard work. And the person that masters doing those little things better than anybody else will be the winner at the end of the day. They might take time if they're not quite as talented, but they will get there. Because hard work, you know, if you're passionate and you want to be the best in the world, hard work is easy. So once a week, or maybe even twice a week, my wife and I like to do what we call a towel workout. It's a different kind of workout. It's still a strength component. I love to do it because I'm allowed to wear my pool boy and give my legs a bit of a rest. And so if I'm a little bit trashed after a big, you know, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday block, we go into a Friday swim and feeling a bit tired, but you know, more your legs are just heavy and they feel like they're dragging on the body than the pool. So a towel workout for us is the opportunity to still work the upper body, give the legs a bit of a break to have the pool boy in there, because I feel like the towel is dragging you back and it's forcing you to really feel the water. So with the towel around your ankle, you really can feel if your elbow's not up and catching good water, you can feel where you're losing it because that towel gets quite heavy. And whereas paddles, I think they're a great training tool, don't get me wrong, and I'll even do paddles with towel, but you lose a sense of feel on your hand. When you put the big plastic paddles on and we all dive in and we all feel fantastic because we're grabbing so much more water, but then you take them off and you feel like you're drowning, you know, missing so much water. So I love to do the towel work because it just allows me to be in a good body position even when I'm tired, but I'm still getting good strength and good feel with the catch. So the bike we did on a few days ago was for me to sit close to my functional threshold power. I don't use a power meter at the moment. I tend to go a couple of years on, a couple of years off. I like to have sometimes a clean head and just go by feel. And so the weekend's ride was, you know, I've ridden that canyon, it's 37 kilometers. I used to time trial it every Saturday through 07, 08, 09. It allows you to really keep the power up, but you don't have to overthink it, you know. So I went up that, I stayed in my 56 chainring the whole way, and that forces me to A, get a lot of strength in the legs, and B, sit at a decent functional threshold of power. And yeah, it was a solid ride, and I turned that ride into, you know, just under a 100-mile ride. It's very flattering to be regarded one of the greatest short course athletes in the world, and a lot of that just comes from my deep passion for the sport, but also to be the best at something. And my passion for the sport is the people around it and the community that we have of triathletes, young and old. I just love being a part of it. I actually enjoy that feeling of going to where I haven't been before and testing myself like I've never tested myself before. But I still truly love the sport, and I'm really enjoying it.